This episode of the Breakthrough Success Podcast is brought to you by Jobber. Jobber is your business's command center. The easy-to-use app powers your sales, operations, and customer service all in one place. Go check them out at getjobber.com/breakthrough to receive 20% off your first 6 months. What's up, Breakthrough Success listeners? Mark Bird, the podcasting coach here, helping people to launch, grow, and monetize their podcasts. And one of the things that really helps you in business and in life are the relationships that you build. And all relationships are built on conversations that are worth having. So in this episode, we're going to share how you can get into more conversations worth having where you are a better participant in the conversation and you are engaging with people who are adding more value to your life and just fun people to be interacting with. So the guests who join us today, we've got a dynamic duo special. The guests are co-authors of the book Conversation Worth Having, which teaches readers how to use appreciative inquiry to fuel productive and meaningful engagement. Our guests have delivered workshops, keynote addresses, and webinars to thousands of people around the world, sharing the appreciative inquiry-based practices and their deep knowledge about the science of appreciative inquiry, positivity, and well-being in personal and organizational life. Our guests who join us for this episode of Breakthrough Success are none other than Sherry Torres and Jackie Stavros. Sherry and Jackie, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. We're delighted to be here. This is Sherry.
And this is Jackie. Thank you, Mark, for that great introduction.
Sherry and Jackie, thank you so much for taking the time to be on Breakthrough Success. And when it comes to conversations, getting in the right conversations can really have such a big impact on your life. And part of that is who you're talking to. So how do you suggest we surround ourselves with people who, like, they are the people who are worth having a conversation with?
So it's interesting in the way you asked that question. I think anyone can be a person worth having a conversation with if you can inspire a conversation that either builds connection or helps uncover their strengths, their gifts that they're bringing into the, whether it's a team or a community, or even into a circle of people where others might not have wanted to get into a conversation with them. The times I'm trying to think of the when you might not want to be in conversation with certain kinds of people is when they're not willing to engage in a conversation worth having, and instead they want to just stay in an argument or stay spiraling or stay negative. And those are the kinds of conversations you want to move away from, because if people are not willing to shift, you're not going to have a conversation worth having. What do you think, Jackie?
I would emphasize that when people are have an open mind and they're willing to get into a conversation where they want to generate understanding, new information, possibilities of how we move forward together, conversations worth having are going to fuel productivity, performance, engagement, satisfaction, everything that's trying to support what you want more of in your team, in your organization.
And also in your life. I mean, if you're really trying to be successful, having those conversations that tap into the knowledge, the wisdom, the ideas of anyone can be very valuable.
And I mean, really great points right away, how like part of it depends on, like, you want to make sure that, you know, you're talking to someone who isn't negative, who is willing to have the conversation. And one of the things I want to address is that you could be in conversation with like some really successful person, but sometimes like people don't necessarily think of that conversation. Then it's like, you have the potential for a great conversation, but it just doesn't happen. It's something really quick, or it's just something that, you know, you just move on to the next conversation quickly. So when we know we're in the presence of someone who we want to have that conversation with, how do we make it a meaningful conversation rather than just one of these like conversations that doesn't really go as far?
This is Jackie, and I would say that's kind of starts with, in our book, we talk about two practices. And in the one conversation that will get you far is one where you're asking what we call a generative question. And a generative question is kind of a great question. It demonstrates that, you know, I'm curious, Mark, with what you want to talk about, or I'm asking a question that I don't have the answer to. And I really want to understand, deepen understanding about a topic or about a connection where I'm trying to build a relationship with you and something meaningful to move forward that's solution focused, productive and engaging, and something that we want to talk about and that we want more of.
And just building on that, if you're faced with somebody who's really successful, ask them questions about their success that would be meaningful to you. Especially if they're successful in a field that you are working to be successful in yourself. People are so often willing to share their wisdom, their ideas. And so asking people, how did you get to where you are? What were some of the key actions that you took? What are the strengths that you bring to what you do? Or tell me about a time when you almost gave up, but you actually kept pushing and you broke through to success. What happened and what did you value about yourself? And in those kinds of conversations, people are going to discover all sorts of things that will resonate with them or that they can learn.
And that's asking questions is... asking the right questions is very important. I mean, that's pretty much what I do on all my podcasts.
Yes.
I just fire off questions and see where they get me. So I definitely say ask a lot of questions and just make sure you're asking all the right ones. Think about it a little bit before you ask your question, then just let it flow based on where the conversation takes you. Now, yeah, in this idea of conversations worth having, you have the scenario where, you know, you're talking with a successful person. There's a lot of different scenarios in the whole conversations worth having. But I feel like one of the conversations worth having is like the harder conversations where you've got to talk about maybe like deeper issues that have had an impact on you for years. And maybe you haven't opened up about it. And some people, they have like a big thing that happened to them. They don't open up about it and it continues to eat at them until they truly like have that conversation. So for the conversations like harder to have, but you know they're worth it, how do you suggest we enter those and keep them going?
So I would say that the first thing to recognize would be if you know what it is that you need to have a conversation about, but you don't want to have it, if you understand that what's going on at your nervous system level, neurologically, is that you are more activated in the R complex of the brain, which is our fight or flight center. And whenever we are coming from a place of fear or high stress, a place of trying to defend something about ourselves, we actually have less access to emotional intelligence, to creativity, and to higher order thinking. And so by staying in that place, we actually inhibit our ability to be successful. So beginning just with an internal conversation of asking yourself questions and getting curious about what is it that's keeping me from either releasing that or looking at that. What might it look like if I did look at that or have a conversation about that? And we will typically turn it into a saber-toothed tiger, and it's not. So finding ways to move beyond those blocks in internally are really important. And often starting with the simple questions of just getting in touch with your own strengths and your own capacities to deal with that and starting with an inner conversation worth having is really valuable. Focusing on what you want rather than what you don't want. So if somebody has a block about opening up and being vulnerable, rather than focusing on that, focusing on being able to be transparent and share and connect with people around whatever that issue is. Jackie, what would you add?
Yeah, you know, I would also add that if you think about your tone and your direction matter. When you started this interview, Mark, your tone and direction was so high energy. It was appreciative. And you're curious. You're asking what and high questions and how questions. And you're thinking about how do I want to frame this conversation and think about the outcome that you want and begin to flip it from the problem, the fear, the challenge to what's the positive opposite. And if that is true, what's really happening here? And so have time to have that, as Sherry said, the inner conversation to think, how do I best move forward?
We have more great content coming up in this episode, but first we have a message from today's sponsor, Jobber. Jobber's award-winning software helps small home service businesses organize their entire operations, from scheduling jobs and managing their crews to invoicing customers and collecting payments. That way, you can spend more time on the services you're already great at. Job by job, business by business, Jobber is transforming the ways their customers deliver service. Start your free trial over at getjobber.com/breakthrough. All right, let's get right back into the episode.
And I do love this talk on the internal conversation, because when people think about conversations, they always think in dialogue with another person. But internally, if you ask yourself questions, you can learn new things about yourself or remember things that you had forgotten for a while. So internal conversations, just throw some questions at yourself and see what happens, because you can learn a lot. And one thing that I also want to tackle is that you hear this more in like the conference space than the conversation space, but I feel like it still applies. So at conferences, people go to this like 2 to 4 day event. They're pumped, they're energetic, they have this whole thing of things they want to do, and they come home and nothing happens with it. They feel empowered for like 2 days, and then it's just back to usual. And I feel like with some of the conversations worth having, you can get into deep, powerful conversations, but then the effects of these conversations can leave you within 2 days, and maybe you felt empowered during the conversation, and then it's like, you know, same as usual. So how can we get out of that same as usual and actually have a longer impact from the powerful conversations we get into?
So this is Jackie, and I always recommend, take a note card and ask yourself when you're at this conference, just write down, what are 3 to 5 things I learned? What are 2 things I'm going to do differently next week or tomorrow? And what's one person I wanted to have a conversation with about what I've learned and what's possible next? So it's just like that, I call it the 5-2-1 formula, and that will kind of get you motivated. And if you just put it on a note card instead of going through your 20 pages of notes, and you keep that note card with you, I think it's going to fuel you to begin to move forward with just maybe doing 2 things of the 5 primary learnings and talking to somebody about the conference.
Yeah, I think part of what happens also is when we get back from the conference, we get back into the ordinary day and the way we have been working, and we don't stop to think about how do I need to either restructure or redesign my day, or what are habits that I need to shift. So for instance, on the card Jackie just mentioned, being able to look at those 5 things that I learned and 3 things I'm going to do differently, and to be able to look at what is it going to take for me to actually do that. And if it's something that in this conversation you realize, oh, I have this habit, I really need to change that, and I need to start asking questions instead of telling people all the time. If that's a habit you want to change, it really requires you taking some time to look at, when am I going to practice that, and how am I going to reinforce that new habit? That can mean partnering with 2 or 3 other people to check in with each other. It can mean looking at how do I restructure my day or the way we're doing work in the office in order to support those new practices or those new ways of being.
And those are some really great points, because a lot of people, they just try to remember the whole thing, the whole event that takes place. And when it comes to conferences, conversations, and everything else, it's just better for you to have a few things that you remember that you really want to focus on. Because like one of the reasons we provide show notes on Breakthrough Success is we don't expect everyone to remember every point that gets mentioned in the conversation. And even with the show notes, you're not going to remember all of it. So that's why, like, for each of these episodes, I like to just grab at least one really good insight that I can hold on to instead of trying to remember the conversation from start to finish. So really great points there. I know we talked a little bit about habits, just like shifting habits from like a conference standpoint. I'm wondering if we could slightly change that a little bit. So can you share with us some of the habits that have helped you each achieve the success that you have achieved?
Sure. So this is Sherry, and I think habits that I have that I've implemented is to not hesitate when there's an opportunity to say yes to it, to jump on it. Even if it means say yes and then figure out how to do it, instead of having to figure out how to do it before I can say yes to it. I don't know whether that's habit or my nature, or whether my nature has driven that into a habit. That habit's also gotten me into trouble sometimes. So, I'm learning to hedge that, but I think if you really want to be successful, saying yes often, and then having the confidence to say, I can make this happen. Another habit is really following through and not allowing myself when I get discouraged about something to just give up. But instead go do something different for a while and then come back, or to seek guidance, to ask for help, to get coaching. There is so much value in having people with greater wisdom and greater experience support you.
And this is Jackie, and I'll build on, there's three habits that I try to work on. And the first one is when I'm in that ain't it awful place or stressed or protect mode, as Sherry said, and we talk about this as well, is that, you know, just take a pause, breathe, and get curious with your questions. So the second habit is, if you think about it, if you ask questions that are appreciative in nature, it's adding value. And when you're just the act of acting questions begins to move you forward. And when Sherry said yes in one of her habits, I used to have a bad habit. I would say, well, yes, but. But if you say yes and, that you can add on to that, versus the but stops you, the BUD, or the and can move you forward. So those are about three habits that I try to work on with my inner conversations and my conversations with others.
Those are really great habits all around. I feel like if you guys over at Breakthrough Success, whether you are driving or grocery shopping or working out, whatever you're doing, if you take in those habits and the other insights from this episode, I feel like you guys are going to have more conversations worth having, and you're going to definitely become a better individual in business and life as well. We will be linking to Sherry and Jackie's book in the show notes, but are there any other places we could go to continue following your work?
Sure. You could go to our website, which is conversationsworthhaving.today. And there you can download a free conversation toolkit, and you can also get the introduction and the preface to our book free of charge. You can just download them.
Well, we'll definitely include all those links in the show notes for anyone who wants to check those out. But once again, Sherry and Jackie, thank you so much for coming on Breakthrough Success. It was such a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you, Mark. And they were great questions.
Yes, thanks,
Mark. Thank you.
This episode of the Breakthrough Success Podcast was brought to you by Jobber. Jobber is your business's command center. The easy-to-use app powers your sales, operations, and customer service all in one place. Start a free trial or sign up today to receive 20% off your first 6 months. Find out more at getjobber.com/breakthrough.